Hello, in this video, we'll explore how to configure and troubleshoot Write-Back in Oracle Analytics. Write-Back feature allows users to update data directly from dashboard and analysis to the database tables. This feature supports both insert and update operations. Here is an overview of the steps to be performed for configuring Write-Back in Oracle Analytics. First, let us open Oracle Analytics RPD in cloud mode and double-click on the physical table containing the column for which Write-Back needs to be enabled. Ensure the cacheable option is not selected for the users to see the updates immediately. Go to the corresponding logical column, select writable option. Now, in the presentation dialog of that column, provide the read-write permissions for the appropriate users and application roles and save the RPD. Secondly, create an XML document, use the Write-Back template with the required parameters. To apply Write-Back template in Oracle Analytics, go to Oracle Analytics console, select system setting, then paste the Write-Back template in Write-Back template XML box. Navigate to Classic Home Administration under Security. Click Manage Privileges and select Write-Back. Grant the Allow Write-Back to Database permission and Manage Write-Back permissions for the required roles. For enabling Write-Back in columns, in Analysis Editor, display the column properties of the column for which Write-Back needs to be enabled. Select the Write-Back tab. Once the column has been enabled for Write-Back, the Enable Write-Back box will be available. Confirm the Enable Write-Back option. Specify the value of other options if required. Save the changes. The column is now enabled for Write-Back analysis that includes this column. To enable Write-Back in table views, in the same analysis editor, open the table view for editing. Select properties, then enable the Write-Back tab. In the template name box, specify the value of web message name. For example, the template name is set age group. Save the changes. Having completed the configurations, validate the Write-Back by opening the analysis created and update the Write-Back column. That is the age group column in this example. Click the update button and the age group column will be editable. Modify as needed and then apply. Click done and we should see the modified values in analysis. Now let us address some common challenges encountered when using Write-Back. Consider a Write-Back report that is failing with the error, the system is unable to read the Write-Back template age group. This can often be attributed to inaccuracies during configuration. Such error generally indicates an issue with the Write-Back template being used. To fix the issue, the Write-Back XML must be validated. In this particular scenario, the age group column ID used in the update statement of XML should be enclosed in single quotes, considering its data type is varchar. Additionally, ensure the correctness of XML. For instance, a space might be replaced with %20 during copy-paste of XML, which would lead to this error. Once validated, test the Write-Back again and the update is now showing successful. A common roadblock arises when the message name specified in the table view editor does not match the one used in Write-Back XML template. Ensure that the web message name specified in table view editor matches the one used in Write-Back XML template. In this case, it was set age group and not set age. Once this is corrected, the update is successful. Moving on to the next scenario, which is encountering the message, the system was unable to generate appropriate XML. This occurs when the field chosen in analysis is flagged as Write-Back field, but the template used does not have an appropriate SQL defined to perform the required operation. Verify the XML and incorporate the additional SQL operations required to resolve the issue. For instance, XML for set product name needs to be added to complete the update. If the error still pops up, even after correcting the XML, it might be due to an incorrect column ID being used in XML template. For example, the column ID reference for product column is incorrectly stated. Correcting this in XML ensures update functions properly. In case the message an error encountered while writing to the server displayed, when updating the Write-Back column, confirms the correctness of the connection tool values used. In the Write-Back XML template, probable cause includes incorrect connection pool details in the XML template or a connection pool with the same name being used under multiple databases in RPD. The connection pool name used in the RPD must be unique and must match the name defined in the RPD. Furthermore, these are some pointers to be taken into consideration when configuring and validating write-back in Oracle Analytics. This concludes the discussion on the write-back functionality in Oracle Analytics. Thanks for watching the video.